Hi, I'm Kathy. You may recognize my hands from previous videos, but you probably don't recognize my face. I am not comfortable in front of a camera, and it has taken a pandemic for me to finally film facing the camera. In April, I offered a class to my customers called my a la carte card class, and they were to match up with me four different stamp sets. And I had four people sign up, and it took 14 projects to get us to match up so that they could get their kits. So I have a lot of projects that are going to be coming up on my channel in the next couple of days. This introduction will be on each and every one of them, but it will down in the bottom here show you the minute mark of where you can skip this introduction and go on to the card making. They will be put in a playlist called April a la carte card class. That's so hard to say. And each one will have that description, the person who signed up for the card, and the stamp set. And that way, as you're making your projects, you can just go to your four projects. Those of you that are just watching to get inspiration, you're welcome to look at any and all of them. And I hope you enjoy it. I hope you stay healthy and safe during this pandemic, and hope that we can all begin to get back together stamping very soon. This card is part of my a la carte April class kit, and this is for Leanne, and this is using the Daisy Delight stamp set, which is retiring at the beginning of June, and this is the card we'll be making. Isn't that pretty? For your cardstock, you're going to need a piece of Knight of Navy that's 5.5 inches by 8.5 inches for your card. You're going to need a piece of So Saffron that measures 5 1/8 inch by 3 7/8 inches. You're going to need a piece of the Pressed Petals DSP that measures 3 3/4 inches by 5 inches. And you do want to pay attention to which direction you're cutting this, because there is a pattern to it that is vertical. So then you'll want a piece of navy that is 1 1/4 inches by 5 inches. A piece of the Pressed Petals DSP that is the Music Notes. And this is 1 1/8 inch by 5 inches. A piece of Very Vanilla that measures 4 inches by 5 1/4 inches for the inside of the card. A piece of the DSP that measures 3/4 inches by 5.5 inches for the inside of the card. A 6-inch piece of the scalloped lace trim for the inside. You'll need some Very Vanilla that is cut using the stitched labels, and it's this die right here that you'll be using, and you'll need two of those. And then finally, you're going to need just a large scrap piece of So Saffron to do the stamping of the daisies and punching them out. So we're going to go ahead and go with that and get our daisy out and ink this up. We're going to need two of them, and you're going to want to stamp where the daisy is vertical, the petals are straight up and down for ease of punching. And we're going to do two of those. We'll do them right next to each other here. And that's in Daffodil Delight ink, if I didn't say that already. And then using Pumpkin Pie ink, we're going to come back with the center. And this is the challenge, is getting this center in the center. And we got two shots at it. I'm always seem to be low, so I'm going to go high on this one and hope that we got it, and we did. Okay, so then we'll take our Daisy Punch and line it up and punch that out. And this one as well. Okay. So then we're going to be layering these two together. And so this one's the one that I'm going to have on top. So we'll put some glue in the center of this one. And I want to offset my petals. Whoop. Just like that. Okay. Now with the Knight of Navy ink, we're going to stamp the inside sentiment, which is this, "Your thoughtfulness brightened my day." That's part of the stamp set. And we'll stamp that in here, just like that. And then we'll take the two little tags. And we need to have our, either the chamois or your stamp cleaner for this. And let me just spritz a little bit in here. Okay. So I'm going to do the U first. And how I'm going to do that is just kind of eyeball and line up so that I'm inking just the U. Just like that. And it's really pretty easy to do without doing the thank. Now just be mindful that you've got this here, but you don't need to worry because that's way over on the side. And I'm gonna come over to the right a little bit, but not too much with it, and stamp. Okay, and then I'm gonna go ahead and clean that. Just in case. And I'm going to do the opposite. I'm going to do the thank this time. And I'm going to ink up the thank. Make sure I get that tail good. Okay. And this one is going to have to go as far as I can to the left. So get those tails right over there against the edge and stamp that. Now, Leanne, I have cut two sets of these for you. So that gives you a couple of shots. I think the U you're going to be fine with, but then that will give you three opportunities to get the thank correct in your kit. But I think you'll be able to do it just fine. All right, so we'll get all that out of the way and start doing some assembly. So we'll start with assembling these two pieces. Now you can see I tried to do it here and I didn't get them close enough so they wouldn't punch out. So, but that's okay because that's going to be hidden by this piece. And those are not cut properly. So let me fix that off camera. Looks like this is too long. Yes, it is. So let me trim this down and I'll be right back with you. Okay, I've got that trimmed down to the correct measurement. Leanne, I'll check your kit before I get it sent to you. Make sure that yours is cut properly. And that's going to give a 16th around the outside edge, just like that. And then this piece will layer on top. And that one's not cut properly either. I must have gotten distracted while cutting, huh? Okay. And then that will go here in the center. Now you can do it right in the center, or you can do it a little bit lower. I'm going to do it just a little bit lower. And then using dimensionals, I'm going to pop these up. So the U will be over here, and you're going to want to have it be all the way out to the yellow, the edge of it, so that your words will be able to be seen with your flower in the center. And this one will be all the way over to this side. Get it centered on here. Doesn't look like I centered the U that well. All right, and then my flower, I'm going to bump up, and I'm going to double bump it. Like that. Place that at the center. Now, just kind of work your petals so that as much of the thank shows as possible. So there you go. And then we'll put that on the front of the card. Like that. And then on the inside of the card, we've got this piece. Turn it around so those flowers are showing more. And then some double-sided the tear and tape. Now on this one, I actually placed it lower. I placed it down on the DSP, where this one I placed it above. I probably would do it this way. Again, if when you're putting your kit together, Leanne, I think it looks a little better than what I've done this time. And then we'll put this in here. And there you go. There is your thank you card using the, let's see, this one is Daisy Delight stamp set.